The quote, "Be kind for everyone you meet is fighting a hard battle," from Ian McLaren, is like putting fresh glasses on our world. I stand at the mall and peer into a sea of eyes and wonder what battles each are facing. I wonder what makes you weary from a hard battle. The battle has been long, and each of us fight wounded. We battle grief and slog through worry and pound out hard marriages, and all of this on the terrain of an already stress-filled life. We battle sins, and although we try to fling them away, sometimes they rebound stronger. We pray and we battle and we get up the next morning and keep fighting. And friend, don't you get the sense that the battlefield itself is covered in chaos? The flag is submerged up there somewhere in smoke, and sometimes the yelling and the cannon shots are so piercing we can't locate his voice at all. We can barely hear a general yelling out the orders. Go where? Do what? And it is into this chaos we hear a voice from Isaiah 40. Comfort ye my people. Speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem and cry unto her that her warfare is accomplished, that her iniquity is pardoned. The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. And here it is in the message. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak softly and tenderly to Jerusalem, but also make it very clear that she has served her sentence, that her sin is taken care of, that she is forgiven. She's been punished enough and more than enough, and now it's over and done with. Thunder into the desert. Prepare for God's arrival. Advent is a time to cry out for he who is the embodiment of hope, our Messiah. We recognize our coping strategies have failed us. We cry out for the King to come, and then we wait. We hold out before us all the pain, but instead of wrestling with it ourselves, we hold it out for him to come, for him to come to our rescue. I remember those years when Andrew and I were deep in the battle, holding up a church and a family. We had 3 kids under 5, exhausting days and sleepless nights, and we hadn't yet discovered the undergirding of mutual trust. Sometimes in the evening after dinner, I would lay down on our bed, solid underneath us, and repeat, "You are holding us up. You are holding us up. We are yours, and you are holding us up." I eventually rested there. Somehow in the waiting, a highway was made of my heart, the way for the King to come. I could have reached for another chocolate, drowned in another chick flick, but I would have missed his coming. Yesterday in church, we sang a Tizé song, "Wait for the Lord, whose day is near. Wait for the Lord, be strong, take heart," from Psalm 27:14, over and over until I felt it settle into my soul. So, beloved daughter, beloved son of the Most High God, your warfare is over. There is a victor, and he is coming. Wait. Be strong. Take heart. Your God is coming.